Random House Audio presents Getting Mother's Body by Suzan-Lori Parks. Read for you by the author. Billy Beede. "Where are my panties at?" I asks him. Snipes don't say nothing. He don't like to talk when he's in the middle of it. "I think I lost my panties," I says, but Snipes ain't hearing. He got his eyes closed, his mouth smiling, his face wet with sweat. In the middle of it, up there on top of me, going in and out. Not on top of me, really. More like on the top of the side of me, 'cause he didn't want my baby belly getting in his way. He didn't say so. He ain't said nothing about the baby yet. But I seen him looking at my belly, and I know he's thinking about it somewhere in his mind. We're in the back seat of his galaxy, a Ford. Bright lemon-colored outside, inside the color of new butter. My head taps against the door handle as he goes at it. "Huh, huh, huh," Snipes goes. In a minute my head's gonna hurt, but it don't hurt yet. "Where?" I go, but he draws his finger across my lips, hushing them so I don't finish. Then he rubs my titty, moving his hand in a quick circle like he's polishing it. I try scooching down along the seat, away from the door, but when I scooch, Snipes is going at it, scooches me right back up against the door handle again. I wonder if my baby's sitting inside me, upside down, and if Snipes' thing is hitting it on its head like the door handle is hitting me on mine's. "Ow," I go, 'cause now my head hurts. "Oh," Snipes go, 'cause he's through. He lays there for a minute, then pulls himself out of me and gets out the car. He closes up his pants while he looks down the road, zipper then belt. In my head, I can see all the little seeds he just sowed in me. All them little Snipeses running up inside of me looking for somewheres to plant. But there's a baby up in me already. A baby Snipes. Baby Snipes knocks down the little Snipe seeds as fast as they come up. "How you doing?" Snipes asks. "I'm okay." I turn from my side onto my back, raising up on both elbows. My house dress is all open, and the baby makes a hump. Snipes turns to look at me, his gold-colored eyes staying on mine's, seeing the hump without really seeing it. He ducks into the front seat, getting his Chesterfields out his shirt pocket, and standing there with his back to me, smoking in just his undershirt. "Penny for your thoughts," I go, but he don't turn around or say nothing. I sit up, buckling my bra and taking a look around for my panties, first in the front seat, then running my hand between the back seat and the seat back, thinking my panties might have got stuck in between, but not finding nothing. Then I do feel a scrap of something and give it a yank. Big, red, shiny drawers. Not mine's. Snipes turns around and sees me holding them. "My sister's," he says, smiling and putting on his shirt. "I let her use my car sometimes." I stuff the drawers back where I found them, first leaving a little red tail sticking out, then stuffing them back in all the way. "I didn't know you had no sister," I says. "I don't know nothing about you." "What you need to know," he says. "What's her name?" "Who?" "Your sister, Alberta," he says. Then he turns away, showing me the side of his face, shaved clean and right angled as my elbow. He's smiling hard, but not at me. "Clifton, can I ask you something else?" "I'll get you some more panties, girl. Don't worry," he says. An hour ago, when Snipes came to get me, I was doing Aunt June's hair. I heard his whistle. He weren't stopped at the pumps. He was stopped across the road, standing against his car, looking cool, waiting for me to come outside, but waiting cool, just in case I didn't show. I seen him and run across the road without even looking to see if cars was coming, and he picked me up and swirled me around, just like Harry Belafonte woulda. "You ain't been around in almost a month," I said, breathless from the swirling. I've been working, girl, he said. He got a custom coffin business. He makes and sells handmade coffins in any shape you want, with plush lining inside and everything. While we drove, he showed me his sample book with 3 new photographs, proud, like folks show pictures of their children. A oak Cadillac, a guitar of cherry wood, and a Pharaoh-style one, too, all big enough to get buried inside. The new one's not painted yet, so folks can pick out their own colors. People been talking, I said. What they saying? Stuff, I said. They saying stuff. We kissed as we drove down the road, and then I started laughing because he was tickling me and getting me undressed and showing me his sample book and driving all at the same time. His left hand on the wheel, his right hand between my legs. Then we pulled off the road. Then we did it. Now we done. I'll get you a whole damn carload full of panties, girl, he says. Them panties you had on is probably along the side of the road, somewhere between here and Lincoln. He smiles, and I smile with him. I remember taking them off. The wind was whipping and must have whipped them out the window while we drove. But that was an hour ago. Now I look down the road, seeing if I can see them. I see somebody down there walking in the dirt and the shimmer from the heat. I don't want to go home without no panties, I says. You worry too much, Snipe says. All the car doors are open and the wind goes through, drying the sweat off the seats. I gotta know something, I says. What? The man's supposed to ask the girl, I whisper. He don't speak. We've been together since March. Now it's July. I want to give him a chance to ask me. You said I wouldn't get bigged the first time we did it, I says. Was our first time your first time? He says. You gonna marry me or what? I says. The words come out too loud. He don't speak. He cuts on the radio, but it don't work when the car ain't running. He gets out, closing the back 2 doors, leaving mine's open, and getting back behind the wheel. Sure, I'm gonna marry you, he says at last. You my treasure. You think I don't want to marry my treasure? People are talking, I says. They just jealous, he says, and we both laugh. Billy Beede got herself a good-looking man, and they all jealous. When we quit laughing, we sit there quiet. You my treasure, girl, he says. You my treasure, capital T, make no mistake. I'm 5 months gone, I says. Too loud again. He wraps his fingers tight around the wheel. I want him to look at me, but he don't. Someone comes up, stopping a foot or two from the car to stare at us open-mouthed. It's Laz. He got his wool cap down around his ears and his plaid shirt buttoned to the chin. You want your ass kicked? Snipes asks him. Not today, Laz says. You don't stop looking at me and my woman, I'ma kick your black ass, Snipes says. Laz looks at the ground. You don't get the hell out of here, I'ma kill you, Snipes says. Being dead don't bother me none, Laz says. He got a bold voice, but he ain't looking up from the ground. Snipes jumps out the car and they stand there toe to toe. Everything Snipes got is better than everything Laz got. Go the hell home, Laz, I says, and he turns and goes. Snipes throws a rock and Laz runs. Goddamn boot black wool hat wearing 4-eyed nigger probably wanted to see us doing it, Snipes goes, getting back in the car and laughing and holding my hand. Peeping and creeping boot black winter hat nigger. Laz is just Laz, I says. His daddy runs the funeral home, but Laz ain't never gonna be running shit, Snipes says, laughing hard and squeezing my hand to get me to laugh too, and I laugh till his squeezing hurts, and I make him let go. Today's Wednesday, ain't it? Snipes says. He looks down the road, seeing his upcoming appointments in his head. I'm free towards the end of the week. Let's get married on Friday. Really? Friday's the day, he says, taking out his billfold. He peeks the money part open with his pointer and thumb, then feathers the bills, counting. His one eyebrow lifts up, surprised. That's what you would call significant, he says. Significant? What year is it? 63. And here I got $63 in my billfold, he says, smiling. He pinches the bills out, folding them single-handed. He reaches over to me, lifting my house dress away from my brassiere and tucking the $63 down between my breasts. Get yourself a wedding dress and some shoes and a one-way bus ticket. I'ma go to Jackson's formal. Get something pretty. Come up to Texoma tomorrow.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.